Muslims today do not have any belief in the promises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of the weakness of iman. Second thing is obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today we ask ourselves, the ummah, Muslim ummah, we look at the whole Muslims today around the world, 1 billion Muslims. How many Muslims any perform in the five-time daily prayers? Just any speak about prayers only, which is any the pillar any of this deen. We find that many Muslims any do not pray. Many Muslims any do not perform any of the prayers. Many Muslims any eat riba. Many Muslims any drink alcohol, for example, all these prohibitions, zina, and so on and so forth. Today, we speak about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How many Muslims regard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as the ultimate example that we are longing to follow? And today, we find Muslims say they are not any contented any with the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You find people, for example, now they say all is backward, 1,400 years. Now we are in the modern technology. We are in the modern day. So we should follow fulan bin fulan. We should follow this particular person. When we put the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is secondary, not any the primary. Primary is other dunya. But if I have time, inshallah, once in a year, maybe you remember the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or once in a month, and so on and so forth. So when we Muslims, we do not pay attention to this importance. When we do not have the strength of iman as required, and we do not obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we are committing ma'siyah, sins after sins, and we do not regard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as our role model in life, then of course, this result will not come. What is the result? The result of peace and tranquility. Peace in society cannot come. So if the Muslims themselves cannot produce this result because of the state that they are in, and they themselves do not understand what is the meaning of this peace that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking about, how do we expect the non-Muslims to understand? So that is why there is a lot of confusion. Today, people has a lot of misconceptions about Islam. And there are debates going on until today. Is Islam is a religion of peace? Many people debate. For example, if a person say yes, Islam is a religion of peace, then people will say, no, you have ISIS, you have this, Al-Qaeda, it's people are killing, so on and so forth. Our answer is yes, in every religion there is a black sheep. Correct or not? But there are Muslims who are peaceful. They are Muslims who obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are Muslims who believe in Allah. They are Muslims who follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Maybe they are in a minority. But these are the people who follow the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you want to understand Islam, look at these people. If you want to understand that Islam is a religion and your peace, then they are the examples. So today we have to be that example, inshallah. Today we have a responsibility. We have any responsibility towards ourselves and Allah, towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, between us and Allah. And we have any responsibility for our community. Whether we are living in Singapore, or we are living in Malaysia, or we are living in Indonesia, no issue. But today, we Muslims, we must always understand that the priority in life is faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's obedience in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is emulating the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the priority in life, in this dunya. And this is what any prophets and messengers has been sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to establish this in the human beings. And if human beings perform this responsibility, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned there will be peace and tranquility. So whenever you see a community, or society, or household, that is in turmoil, then you will understand that the reason for this turmoil, and you go back to the things that we mentioned earlier. The reason for this turmoil is lack of iman. The reason of this turmoil is disobedience to Allah. The reason for this turmoil is ma'asiyah, and do not make tawbah to Allah. The reason any of this turmoil is not any following any of the advices of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So today, subhanallah, the Quran and give us any answers towards any of the problems any that you are facing. Just any this particular verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us any of the answers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, make the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as your role model. If you make the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as your role model, that is your door for success in dunya and akhirah. But today, if we make other than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as our role model, we will not attain any success. We will not enjoy any peace in anything. Because why? Because then we do not fulfill any of the conditions, so we cannot attain the result. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy upon us. We pray that Allah make this gathering a reason that Allah enliven our hearts, first thing with iman and yaqeen. This is important. We have to find ways how to strengthen our iman and how to attain love towards Allah. That's what we mentioned earlier. Because love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is a motivating factor that guides you to do amal, amal salih, to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have to think, how are we able to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything that Allah has commanded us? And how are we able to refrain from maasiyah? Even if we fell into a sin, quickly we make tawbah to Allah. Oh Allah, forgive. So we make Allah our maqsood. And we study the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and try our best to emulate ittiba, to follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his daily things, entering the toilet, going out any of the toilet, entering of the masjid, all these things that we do every day before we sleep, and the dua before we sleep. We can start with this simple dua. After we wake up from our sleep, try our best to be in a state of wudu, for example. I'm just giving examples. So we try our best to make the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as our example in front of us. Our maqsood. This is the door for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the door that I will enter into success in dunya and akhirah through the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So if we rectify this mentality and this perception to the correct any perception, and we promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that now, inshallah, by tonight, I will start, inshallah. And may Allah make this gathering, inshallah, a reason that Allah motivate us, put in us this ability and this important in our hearts, and make it easy upon us to walk this path, because this is the path of prophets and messengers. This is the path of the pious. And this is what we do make dua in Surah Al-Fatiha. Ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. Sirat al-ladina an'amta alayhim. This is the path of the nabiyin wa siddiqin wa shuhada'i wa salihin. وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا. This is what we want in this life. Because this is the thing that will save us in dunya and save us in akhirah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy upon us, inshallah. And may Allah bless all of us, inshallah, in this majlis with tawfiq. That we go out from this majlis and instead, inshallah, Allah bless us and guide us and hidayah. But of course, we also must have readiness to accept. But if our hearts are not ready, for example, or do not want, then problem. Allah is willing to give you. But what is important is you must be willing to accept. So if you are willing, inshallah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless. So this is what Allah mentioned, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu dukhulu fi silmi kafa. Wa la tattabi'u khutuwati shaytan. And do not follow the footsteps of the devil. Do not follow the footsteps of the devil. What is the meaning, do not follow the footsteps of the devil? So let me give you an example. You see, the devil, Shaitan has a strategy for believers. I always mention this. That the work of the devil is to deviate the believers from Allah. This is basically what he's being tasked to do. And what he wants to do. For every Muslim and every mu'min, when you have belief in Allah, if you have iman in your heart, and if you feel this importance in your heart to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you must understand that there is an enemy waiting for you. This is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you see, after this verse, then Allah speaks about shaitan. Why? Because the moment you make this decision, you must understand that you will face an enemy. Because you make this decision, now he knows that you are going to the right path. And he wants you to deviate. He doesn't want you to pray. He doesn't want you to believe. He doesn't want you to be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He wants you to deviate from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to do something else. So when he understands that you are taking this path, what is the path we were speaking about? The path of silm, right? Enter into silm. This piece that I was speaking about, the deen. When he found out that you have made the decision to follow this path, then he will try his best to deviate you. But how does he deviate you? This is another thing. So let me give you an example. Shaitan, when he looks at a person, he has any different strategies for different people. It depends on what is your level of understanding. For example, if he looks at all of us, I'm just giving an example, and we have to understand this enemy. When he looks at all of us, he finds that, okay, these people are coming to the masjid. Meaning what? Meaning you have iman, you believe that going to the masjid is important, and this is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is important to learn the Quran. It is important to perform the prayers, and you are performing prayers, alhamdulillah, quite a daily prayers. You have this importance in you. So he knows that. Now he is thinking how to debate these people from Islam. He knows that if he tells you, for example, do not go to the masjid, do not pray, he knows that you will not take any resources. So he has a plan B. What is the plan B? Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in the hadith, al-ma'asi baghidatul kufri. Al-ma'asi baghidatul kufri. Sins is a gateway for disbelief. Remember this. This is a principle. Sins is a gateway for disbelief. If shaitan cannot make you a disbeliever, meaning he tells you, do not believe in Allah, do not believe in the Prophet, he knows that he will not do it. What will he do? He will try his best to snatch away the iman from you by telling you to do maksiyah, by telling you to do sin. If he has the opportunity for you to backbite others, for example, and he comes and he increases waswas and tells you, you know your friend is like this, you know your friend is like this, who is this, he is jealous of you. Now he's thinking bad of you. This particular person is like this. He doesn't like you because he likes this and this. Now he decided to think, you say, yeah, correct. This particular person is jealous of me. I do not like this person. This person, I'm better than this person. Now he has engaged you. Now you have fallen into the trap of this shaitan, you start to have bad intention. When you start to have any bad intention, you start to backbite. You know this person like this, maybe he thinks he's good. Now when you start to backbite, you're committing any sin. When you're committing any sin, your iman becomes weaker and weaker and weaker and weaker. Al-ma'asi baghidatul kufri. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that ma'asiyah, sins, is a gateway for disbelief. Meaning, if a person is committing sin after sin, it is feared that this sin will make him come into a state of kufr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he's not careful. If a person is committing sin after sin and doesn't making tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, slowly what happens, the iman will be weaker and weaker and weaker and weaker. And this is what shaitan wants. When your iman is weak, when you start to leave prayers, for example, shaitan will tell you, why you want to do bitter prayers? Why you want to do this dua prayers? Sunnah. Don't need. Just do the fard. Enough. So any say, yeah, correct. And inshallah, I do the fard, then you start slowly to leave off the sunnahs, leave off the witri prayers, and leave off with that. And then after that, they tell you, why must you pray at the masjid? You can pray at your house. And you pray at your house, and it may be better. Your house, and you will be more tranquil. You will be silent in the Quran, adhan in the house. better than you come to the masjid. So you say, if you don't have knowledge, yeah, all right. Better. Now he's successful now. So from coming to the masjid, now you are praying at home. From performing any the witr and the sunnah, now you are only praying the fard. He feels, okay, this is success. So now after that he tells you are praying at home. No need any to pray at the early time in your prayers. Pray later. Rest. So he says, yes, correct. Maybe I'm tired. Yeah. So now you start to delay your prayers. Last time you pray Zohar and 1:30, now you pray at 2:30. After that, 3:30. After that, and before Asr, again, you start to pray. At last, anyone happens, and you leave and it is over prayers. And then Shaitan, and he will tell you, you are now, sometimes you pray, sometimes you do not pray. Better don't pray. Then slowly, and this person, and he leaves any prayers. And I'm just giving an example, but these things are happening, correct? And you find, for example, there are people last time come to the masjid, now they come to the masjid. Last time you find, mashallah, this particular brother always praying, but he's not praying anymore. This happened. We are not really seeing any things like examples it's difficult for us to imagine, but we see this with our very, very own eyes. This is the strategy of Shaitan. Why is he doing this? The strategy is this. So we have to understand our enemy. The strategy is, if you are praying, make you less pray. If you are obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make it less. If you do not do ma'asiyah, do a bit more ma'asiyah. So this is a strategy of Shaitan. If you don't backbite, do a bit of backbiting. If you don't start quick, fitna, now you do fitna. If you do not, if you perform any prayers, then slowly, he trying his best for you to leave any all this obedience. And this inclusive coming to the masjid, performing the sunnah, fasting, obedience to the parents, and so on and so forth. The reason why he's doing any all this is this: al ma'asi baghidatul kufri. So you must understand this principle. That the moment slowly you leave your amal salih, and slowly you are committing sins after sin, sin after sin, what is happening to you? Now the thing that is happening to you is that your iman becomes weaker and weaker and weaker and weaker without you realizing. And when death comes, what happens? And this is the time that Shaitan and he will try his best. If a person is in a state of weakness and in iman, it is feared that when death comes, he dies in su'ul khatiman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from this musibah. Our ulama, they mentioned that the biggest calamity is to die in su'ul khatiman. The biggest calamity. There is no calamity than dying in a state of disbelief. No calamity that is greater. Even if a person lives in this dunya, miskeen, from the day he was born until the day he passed away. But if that's in iman, he's successful. But even if a person, he was born in this dunya as a king and died as a king, but dying in disbelief, this is the biggest calamity. The person who's living in poverty all his life, but dies in iman, now he is a successful person. So the biggest musibah or alama he mentioned is to die in the state of kufr. And this is what the devil wants from us. For people who have iman. For people who doesn't have iman and he's gone, he said, no problem. Yeah, you just leave them. For people who doesn't have iman, doesn't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Shaitan and he will not waste his time. Right? Shaitan and he will put in efforts in who? In the mu'minin. Because you have something that he wants, that is iman, faith in Allah. He doesn't want any to make ibadah. He doesn't want you any to have ibadah to Allah. If you make ibadah to Allah, you try to mess any to cut your ibadah. If you start any to do the tahajjud prayers, and he will tell you, you know what, you are tired, this. No need, yeah. Pity you, you know, in the morning and you have to go to work and all these things. And you incur any all these waswas. If you are not careful, you fell into any trap, any of waswas. And this trap, any of waswas, and it's not something that is easy. You might think any this kind of whispers and it's easy, but it is not. Sometimes you do not know that these whispers come from Shaitan. You thought that it is from you, from your own thoughts. But this is any min sharri waswasil khannas. It's what Allah says in the Quran. Qul a'udhu bi rabbin nas, malikin nas, ilahin nas. What did Allah tell us? Min sharri waswasil khannas. Allah Ta'ala said the importance of seeking refuge to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the whispers yani of Al-Khannas. Al-Khannas is from the names of Shaitan. And one of the ways yani, for us yani, to protect ourselves yani, from the whispers of Shaitan is remembrance yani, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you remember Allah, Shaitan will go away from you. When you are in a state of neglectfulness, Shaitan yani, will come and try in his best yani, to overpower you. So that is why for a person who has zikrullah, it is difficult any for Shaitan yani, to delude him and knowledge. There is a saying, one alim is more difficult any for Shaitan to delude than 1,000 abid. Knowledge yani, is a weapon, ya jama'ah. That is why we are studying tafsir. We are studying yani, all these things. Because without knowing all these things, yani, you will not know. You do not know about the nature of the whispers yani, of Shaitan. How do you know? How do you know that you are whispered by Shaitan? There is a way to know. If you study about the nature of these whispers, you can tell. But if you don't study, you cannot tell. You might be thinking, mashallah, it's ilham from Allah, maybe. You do not know. How do you know when you study, when you read books of tasawwuf, when you read books any of spirituality, read books like Ihya Ulumuddin, Bidayatul Bidayah. These are the books, and if you read Imam Ghazali especially, will speak about how to know that this is a waswas of Shaitan, or what you call it, this inspiration, ilham. How do you differentiate? There is a way. Now, inshallah, when we have time, maybe I can cover some of this. But this is the reality today, that if you are not careful, we can fall into the trap of Shaitan. So we have to protect ourselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Do not follow the footsteps of Shaitan. Why any footsteps? Because Shaitan will delude you slowly. Step by step. Khutuwat. Because he knows that it is impossible for him to change you overnight. Impossible. He knows that. Shaitan is not stupid. It's not like someone yani, who doesn't have a mind. Allah bless them yani, with minds. They are able yani, to think and plan. Correct. Look at Iblis la'natullah alayhi in the Quran. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cursed him, and what did he say? He said, oh Allah, by your greatness. This is what he said. Bi'izzatika. Meaning, and he has aql. He knows the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not any someone who is ignorant. But he knows the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, oh Allah, by your greatness, give me time. Andirni ila yawmi yub'athun. Give me time until any day I resurrected. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, فَإِنَّكَ مِنَ الْمُنْذَلِينَ. You are given any that time. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave any Iblis postponement. He is alive from that time until today to delude and insult any of Adam. So you think this makhluk any like Iblis, yani it's a creature and it is ignorant, jahil or stupid, that is not any the case. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, they are able to see us min haythu la tarawnahum. You do not have the ability to see the shaitan, but shaitan and he can see you. So that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught us, when you want protection any from shaitan, fasta'idh billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Only Allah can protect you from shaitan. Because shaitan and he has power. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless any shaitan with things better any than human beings. Better than human beings. But at the same time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us and give protection. But the condition is that there is zikrullah. There must be remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will protect us from the evils of evil sin of the devil. So inshallah ta'ala, the time is coming for Isha. We will stop here inshallah. And we continue next week inshallah ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us and give us tawfiq. ربنا تقبل معنا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اختم الصالحات عملنا وعالنا الله يكرمك فضل سبحان ربي رب العزة عما يصفون سلام على المرسلين الحمد لله رب العالمين.